Hello everyone and welcome to Wolfram Language for Python Users webinar. My name is Adora Banmas and I work in the marketing team here at Wolfram Research Europe. The topic today will be presented by Daniel Robinson, content author and technical consultant here at Wolfram.
Thank you very much. Hello and welcome everybody. Welcome to this webinar about Python and the Wolfram language, creating a unified workflow. So the way this notebook is set out is a little bit like a sort of, it's a bit like an advertisement for Mathematica and Wolfram language and stuff, but that's not really what I want today's talk to be about. I want to just demonstrate to you how you can unify the two programming languages. So you might be a long-time Python user and perhaps you're at university and you're just starting to use Mathematica. Or you may be a long-time Mathematica user and you want to integrate some Python into your workflow. Well, I'd just like to show you just how you might do that. So I'm going to begin by just going over a brief history and comparison of the two languages. I'm going to show a bit more about the Wolfram language, just in case you're not aware, you might not be familiar with it. We're going to go through some examples that I think better show how they compare. And then we're going to actually move over into a Python environment in some Jupyter notebooks. And I'm going to be, let's see what I'm going to be covering. I'm going to be covering some basic usage, serialization. So that's sort of turning it from Python into Wolfram language code. Some cloud connectivity stuff, because writing APIs in Wolfram language is actually really, really easy. So this is one area I'd say is quite a good way to get into the language. And then finally, some Wolfram language in practice, rather some Wolfram language hybrid Python language sort of project, you know, how to actually unify them. And finally, if we have time, we'll just like sort of look at some more Wolfram applications. But yeah, that's if we have time. Okay, so without further ado, so key questions. Suppose, you know, you want to use Wolfram language and or Python, how do they stack up to one another? Which one is useful in what area? What is transferable between the two? And what are the best practices for a combined experience? So these are some of the questions I'd like to answer today. First of all, a brief history of the two languages. So Python was first published in 1991. Currently, I checked yesterday, I believe, they're on version 3.11.1, but it's not really so important now that we're on version 3. If you're still in version 2, I'd highly recommend switching over. But yeah, anything in version 3 is usually okay. I believe we're on 3.10 in the Jupyter notebooks today. It's an object-oriented language, so everything is, you know, you've got these sort of objects that can then be manipulated. They have attributes, properties, methods, you know, and it's all based on objects. And there you can have notebook environments. So apparently there were IPython notebooks. I wasn't aware of this, but you're probably more familiar with Jupyter notebooks, which were also inspired by Mathematica notebooks. And we'll be using some of those today. So that's Python. Mathematica actually came out before Python, which many people are often surprised about. Yeah, Wolfram language is very old. We're currently on version 13.2. That's actually what I'm using today. I might be using a slightly beta version. I can't remember. So if something does go wrong, that's probably because I'm using a dodgy version of the software. So Wolfram language, Mathematica rather, is a combined kernel and front-end experience. So that brings us over to this section here. You know, what is the difference between Mathematica and Wolfram language? Well, Mathematica is what you see here. It is the interface, you know, it's what you might call the IDE, where behind the scenes, there is what we call a kernel. This is the thing that's doing the actual computation. And then at the forefront for the user, there is this front-end notebook that you see here. So Mathematica is the combination of the two. And the Wolfram language is the programming language we use to write code. So anytime you see me writing code like this, this is Wolfram language code. Sorry. A big part of Wolfram language is the fact that the computation is symbolic. So this is a little bit different to other languages like Python, where although you can do symbolic computation, you tend to sort of have to think about whether something is an integer or a float, that kind of thing. Whereas a lot of the time in Wolfram language, you can stick anything in there and it will give it a go because it's all symbolic under the hood, and we'll see a bit of that later on. And the key thing that Wolfram language does is it tries to emphasize automation. So basically, as we'll see, there are a lot of high level there's a lot of high level functionality in the language that means that there's very little for you to have to do as the user. You can do machine learning without ever having done it before with just a couple of lines. It's really easy to get into. Although to sort of get into the finer details, that's often a tricky part. And being proprietary software, it's not always necessarily easy to dig down. So that's one of the cons of the language. So yeah, I've discussed that. So just in case you're not familiar between how the two languages compare, because I'm sure some of you out there are pros in either one or the other, they're actually really quite similar. So they, in this regard especially, they're both highly into data science. If you want to get into data science, then something like Python or Wolfram language, those are the languages to learn. They're highly compatible with many IDEs, high level languages. So, just as I've mentioned, you're going to have functions that can do a lot of the work for you. Now, in the Wolfram language, that should be fairly easy to obtain, whereas in Python, you'll probably have to know the right libraries. But, if there is one out there, then it probably does the job. And perhaps we should focus on the differences, because this is where, this is where for me, it really matters for a lot of people. So Python obviously is open source, completely free, completely open source. But of course, there are a number of there are various implementations. So Python 2, 3, I guess there are different versions, like you can have web versions and stuff. And because of that, it's not always forwards backwards compatible, which is, it can be very annoying if you have multiple versions of Python on your machine, for example. Libraries getting imported into the wrong place, it can be a bit of a mess unless you're quite careful and know what you're doing. And obviously, it's very relies heavily on external libraries. Wolfram language, single source, developed completely in-house at Wolfram Research. Which means it's very consistent and it's centralized, loads of documentation, but obviously it's paid for software. And some of the one downside is that certain functions are sort of black box functions. You don't know what's inside them. So you can be confident that it's doing things right, and that the data that it's using is up to date and it's clean and it's correct, but you just have to trust it. Because it's a black box, and not many people, people don't always like that. So obviously, there's a great deal of functionality straight out of the box with Mathematica, but this bar, of course, shoots right up when you consider all of the external libraries available to Python. All right, so that's spoken a little bit of a while about, comparing the two, but I'd like to just look a little bit more into the syntax. Because not many people are aware that the languages are actually really, really similar. So obviously these are the actual finer details with how they compare. I suppose a big one for some people would be that the indices start at one in Wolfram language, which I personally prefer, but obviously a lot of people are used to indexing on zero. And another one that I think is quite a big deal for me is that you can do inline comments. Which is not so easy to do in some languages. But if we actually look at two examples here, so I've just written out how, a function to find prime numbers, I believe. Yes, determine whether or not a number is prime. But what I've done is I've written it both in Python and in Wolfram language. I'm not saying this is the best way to write it in either, but the reason why I've done this is because, as you can see, they're really, really similar. The syntax is basically the same. And that means that if you are a Python expert, you can actually you can almost copy the code across into Mathematica and it'll, be 90% of the way there. And of course, in Wolfram Language, being a functional language, there are often many different ways of doing the same thing. So this might be a different way that you might want to do it. So just in case you're not familiar, this is how you might write a function in Wolfram Language. I'm overloading my definition here to say that, this prime check function looks for a number, default value one, and this is what it does. However, in all other cases, it does this and actually does the computation. So if I evaluate that, then I can just run it against three numbers. One is not prime, seven is, and 10 is not. And in this case, it finds the prime factors. So basic stuff, but I just wanted to emphasize the fact that in Wolfram language, at least you can do things in many different ways, as I'm sure you can in Python.